You've been told high cholesterol causes heart disease, but what if that's only part of the story? In this episode, we'll look at what your LDL, HDL, triglycerides, ApoB, and inflammation really reveal about heart health, how insulin resistance, low-carb diets, and age can change those numbers, and what it means for your long-term heart health. Welcome to Health Investigations, where we separate myth from measurable science. Before we begin, this video is for education only. Consult your healthcare provider for health advice. What if cholesterol was never the enemy? Around 75% of your cholesterol is made by your liver because it's essential. Your body uses it to build hormones, cell membranes, and even vitamin D. So cholesterol isn't the problem. It's how it travels that matters. Cholesterol rides through your bloodstream on tiny transporters called lipoproteins. LDL delivers it to your cells, and HDL carries it back to your liver for recycling. Issues arise when too many small LDL particles slip into artery walls, sparking inflammation and forming plaque. A 2020 Lancet study showed that heart disease is driven by far more than cholesterol. Factors like blood pressure, obesity, and lifestyle all play major roles. Cholesterol matters, but it's only one piece of a much bigger puzzle. We've been told LDL is bad and HDL is good, but what if it's not that simple? LDL's job is to deliver cholesterol, like trucks carrying supplies to your cells. The problem arises when there are too many trucks, or when they're small and leaky. A 2022 review in Biomedicines found that small, dense LDL particles are more likely to penetrate artery walls and trigger inflammation, but not because of size alone. It's about numbers. That's where ApoB comes in. It counts how many LDL particles are on the road. In 2007, researchers writing in the Journal of the American College of Cardiology found that when ApoB is considered, LDL size no longer predicts heart disease risk. And HDL is your cleanup crew, but even the cleanup system can malfunction. A 2023 review in the American Journal of Preventive Cardiology revealed that a very high HDL, above 90 to 100 microgram per deciliter, can be linked to higher mortality. Inflammation, infections, and autoimmune issues can make HDL dysfunctional. So maybe the real question isn't what's good or bad, it's how well is my system working together? Could triglycerides be the missing clue? Triglycerides are fat formed from excess sugar and calories. High triglycerides often point to insulin resistance, meaning your body struggles to manage fuel. A study published in the Journal of the American Medical Association in 1996 found that higher triglycerides predicted heart attacks even when LDL levels looked normal. When triglycerides rise and HDL drops, it signals metabolic distress, a warning long before cholesterol becomes a problem. Maybe the real story isn't about cholesterol particles alone, but the environment they move through. Could inflammation be the real driver behind heart disease? Inflammation begins as the body's repair signal, but when it never stops, it becomes destructive. Smoking, stress, and high blood pressure irritate artery walls. LDL can then become trapped and oxidized, setting off more inflammation and more plaque. In 2025, the European Heart Journal published a 14-year study of over 322,000 people. Researchers found that when LDL, LPA, a genetically influenced form of LDL linked to inflammation and clotting, and inflammation were all high, the risk of heart disease skyrocketed, even when drugs were prescribed. The takeaway? Lowering cholesterol helps, but calming inflammation may be just as vital. What if higher cholesterol doesn't always mean danger? especially as we age. A 2016 BMJ open analysis reviewing 68,000 older adults found that most with higher LDL actually lived longer. A 2025 study in nutrients echoed this. Elders with LDL above 130 micrograms per deciliter had a lower risk of death. That doesn't mean high LDL causes longevity. It simply reminds us that context matters. So maybe the question isn't, is LDL bad? But in whom and under what conditions? Suppose you start a low-carb or ketogenic diet and your LDL rises. Should you worry? Studies in Archives of Internal Medicine of 2006 and Missouri Medicine of 2022 show that low-carb diets often lower triglycerides, raise HDL, and shift LDL toward larger, less harmful particles. But some individuals, often due to genetics, experience a rise in LDL and ApoB. That's why testing matters more than labels. The question isn't, is keto good or bad? It's, is it improving your metabolic health? So what should you do if your doctor says your cholesterol is high? The key is to look beyond that one number and ask for the full picture. Here's what matters most. ApoB. How many LDL particles are circulating? Triglyceride to HDL ratio. A window into your metabolic health. High sensitivity CRP. A marker of inflammation that drives heart disease. LPA. A genetic factor most standard tests overlook. And here's what you can influence. Cut back on sugars and refined carbs to lower triglycerides. Stay active and eat omega-3s to support HDL. Prioritize sleep, manage stress, and choose whole nutrient-rich foods. In some cases, such as diabetes and autoimmune conditions, a well-formulated ketogenic diet may be worth considering. As research shows, it can have strong anti-inflammatory effects. Because cholesterol is just one marker, not the full story of your health. There is an old saying in medicine, treat the patient, not the lab result. Numbers matter, but they're not the full picture. Heart disease is shaped by how your cholesterol, inflammation, and metabolism interact. When we understand these markers, we're not just protecting ourselves, we're protecting our families for years to come. Thank you for watching Health Investigations. If you found this episode helpful, subscribe, share, and comment with the next health myth you'd like us to investigate. Until next time, stay critical, stay proactive, and stay healthy.